everybody! Hello! I'm so happy to be here and I hope you enjoy this video. My name is Felicity Kazadi. Chiyamba, Feli, anything you want to call me. But yeah, that's it. I am from the DRC, or the DR Congo, aka the best country on the African continent and probably in the world. So, you get the idea. What is my biggest dream?
I have a dream!
My biggest dream in the world is to accomplish all my dreams.
What?
I don't know if that makes sense, but that is my biggest dream, to accomplish all my dreams and also to influence change, to influence the change that I want to see in the world. If you wanna make the world a better place, take a look at yourself, then make a change. So yeah, that's my dream. It's a very interesting question. So currently I am a student. I am doing my master's in economics and politics, but I also am the founder of an initiative called Congo Talks 243.
What's up everybody, my name is Felicity and welcome to Congo Talks 243.
It has a YouTube channel on here and it also has an Instagram page. I'm not promoting it, but you can follow if you want to. It's pretty cool. I didn't choose it. I feel like it chose me. I didn't choose it. It was just there, and I felt like every step that I'm taking towards it is just, it's just happening, to be honest. You know, it's not something that I actively am pursuing, but it has always been there. So I didn't choose it. It chose me.
Okay.
I speak 4 languages. I also understand Hindi, for example. Okay. I speak 4 languages. Yeah, I speak Kikongo, Lingala, French, and English, as you can see. But I also understand Hindi. Don't ask me how. D'accord. Bonjour, je m'appelle Félicité. Je suis du Congo, Congo Kinshasa. Et puis le français me semble pas trop facile, quoi. Donc je parle pas trop français parce que voilà, j'aime l'anglais.
Pardon. Les français c'est pas ma langue.
Et je préfère l'anglais que Zambé. I just stop there. The 4 national languages of Congo, by the way, for those of you who don't know, it's Lingala, Kikongo, Swahili, and Chiluba. So I'm gonna try to give some greetings in the 4 national languages. So in Lingala, we say Mbote. In Kikongo, they can also say Mbote, but they also say Kiambote. For those of you who are from the Congo Central side of Congo, and yeah, okay, I'm just gonna list them. Mbote, Kiambote, Jambo, Betuabu. I'm so proud of myself. I don't know if it's funny, but there's a fun fact about Australia. It's the fact that Australia is home to the deadliest animals. To be honest, like anything that you can think of that is deadly lives in Australia. Like the deadliest spiders, the deadliest snakes, the deadliest crocodiles, all of them can be found in Australia. funniest thing that you can only find in Congo is funny people. I really feel like Congolese people are very funny. I don't know if it's because I'm Congolese, but to be honest, you really have to grab, you know, you have to grab the Congolese people to actually understand how funny they are. You know, I really feel like Congo is like Nigeria, but it's like the French version. These two countries are home to the funniest people. And maybe a little bit Ivory Coast. But these countries are home to the funniest people, so yeah, I guess. I actually do not have celebrity crushes.
Mensonge.
Period. I do not, whether they're Congolese or not. Okay, I feel like the way that I see it is different. There are people that inspire me, but I don't regard them as my crushes, as in like I wouldn't get involved with them romantically or anything. No, I don't really imagine people like that. So my only crush is my man. I would say it's probably Sandrine Mubenga. I don't know if you guys know her. I think they call her Sandrine Ngalula as well.
I have a big battery bank. The cells are connected in series. So you can picture the cells as glasses of water.
It's one of her names, actually. I think it's Sandrine Ngalula Mubenga, or Sandrine Mubenga. Basically, she's a Congolese engineer, and her specialties is in renewable energy. She used to be a professor in the US, but now, right now, she's working with the Congolese government to kind of like improve Congo's energy sector. I think she's a queen and I admire her.
Perfect.
To be honest, I have not really explored my career that much to make that decision, so I'm still discovering what life has to offer as far as my career choices are concerned. But if it's just a question about me as a person, I would love to be myself.
I want to thank me for believing in me.
I love being myself, so it is what it is.
It is what it is.
It is what it is.
The best Congolese tribe for me is Congolese people.
Funka!
I really think, you know, like Congo, all the Congolese tribes are what makes Congo so special and so exciting. You know, it's very diverse and I love that fact.
RDC.
If I was God for one day, oh my gosh, what would I do? I would take out a lot of politicians, especially on the African continent. Oh, I will take them out. Take them out. Rebuild the whole whatever. But because it's only one day, maybe I wouldn't be able to do so much. But if I'm God, then I have a lot of power. So that means I can change a lot of politicians. I can build roads in a lot of cities in Africa, for example. I could destroy a lot of dangerous weapons. Politically, I feel like if I was God for one day, I would accomplish a lot in the political field. Yeah. I really enjoyed this video. You know, more people should do this. Thank you so much, Blody. for inviting me here. I enjoyed it, and I hope you guys also got to enjoy having me here, giggling and saying nonsense sometimes. And I would invite you guys to subscribe to the Glowdeville Studio, this channel where you are seeing me from. And on my own account, I would like you guys to follow me. On social media, I am Feli Kazadi. I'm also KongoTalks243. And on YouTube, I am KongoTalks243. But I would suggest you guys follow me on Instagram, KongoTalks243, because my personal Instagram page is kind of getting crowded and it's private now. So I'm just allowing the people that I like. Maybe you can follow me. If I like you, I'll let you in. So thank you so much, guys, for tuning in. And I said that already, but thank you for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this video. Follow me on social media. Follow Glowdeville Studio. And I will see you guys next time. Bye. I would say it's tribalism and French.
I don't like what you did in front of me. Go outside.
Get rid of French, get rid of tribalism, and we're good. Look, just like we were before colonizers. I'll stop there. I would say Dakar. I don't care. Dakar. Fumbwa. I would kill to just go back home and eat fumbwa and kwanga and salted fish, which we call makayabu.
It's called fumbwa. Where I come from, we call this fumbwa.
Fumbwa.
What? So wait, don't start yet.
Sorry, I get
it. We do it together. And this, it's called kwanga. You eat this with the soup.
Do we unravel it?
Yes, open it.
So you do presents.
Yeah. Huh? This is kind of fun. Wait,
dunk it. First step. Cut like this. Second step, inside. And then.
Very good.
Wow. I've never had anything like this.
Serge, I don't want this going to your head, but this may be the best soup I've ever had.
Okay. So, fumbwa, kwanga, and makayabu, my jam. Actually, the thought of not being born Congolese kills me. But if I was not Congolese, I would love to be from any country on the African continent. As long as I'm African, I'm good. Congolese or Ivorians, who are the best? Congolese, of course, is that even a question?
Si tu devais avoir une nationalité, c'était la nationalité congolaise. Non, Congolais, vous connaissez le travail. Non, Congolais.
In music, in food, in vibes, and everything. Congolese, I love you guys. If you're Ivorian and you're watching this, I love you. But Congo is the best. No. No. I don't visualize myself in that position. Maybe in the future I would start visualizing myself in that kind of position, but right now no. It's not my goal at all to be the president of the DRC. If it happens, I feel like the Lord himself would kind of push me. He would push me to the stage. But if it's just me, I'll be there. I'd rather just influence positive changes in the world, in my country, in Congo. And it doesn't need to be political. It could just be cultural. But then again, I feel like everything that I do right now is somehow political, but maybe not to the, I wouldn't take it to the level of being the first female president of Congo. Maybe not. Maybe, I don't know. We don't know what the future holds. Yes, all Congolese people can dance, but some Congolese people can dance more than others. You know? And I am one of those Congolese people who cannot really dance. I mean, we can move it, you know? We can all dance. Actually, yeah, all Congolese people can dance.